And we back.
With another session.
Present Kings Unfiltered.
Session.
Session six,
man.
Hey.
You up to six now.
I'm aware of shaking and baking, moving.
Yeah,
grooving.
Yes, sir.
How was y'all week? I hope y'all week was good. Our week was good. Real long. That's why we coming to y'all a little late. We apologize, but we here.
Yeah, man, we coming to y'all real late, but Better late than sorry. Sorry than late. I don't know. But you know, we just bring you another session. We having technical difficulties. The mic's going out of there. We just had a little long week. We've been partying ever since fucking Thursday, Wednesday.
The CIAA in Baltimore.
We got some footage, man. Some footage, you know, I mean, everything didn't just make it because, you know, we was really shaking and moving. You know what I'm saying? It was some places were too packed.
Like this. Well, you know what I'm saying? Locked down head. You know, couldn't even move.
We was really, you know, just trying to enjoy our time as well as, you know, trying to make some content or whatever we was trying to do. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
At the same time, man, we're going to get it started with our first topic of how we always do. We always got topics. You know what I'm saying? Dre, man, always going to tell you something. He always going to teach you something. You know what I'm saying? So just
sit back,
lay back, vibe with us, man. I mean, we're going to get into our first topic. Our first topic is gonna be a little doozy one, man. But you know, man, it's been crazy, man. So since the CIAA, we wanted to say trim because that's my little word that I made up when I went to Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? So little trimmage. But we gonna just say scamming, man. Just scamming, man. You know what I'm saying? All scamming, man. CIAA was a big ass scam, man. To bring all these people in here, man, to scam their ass out of these little crazy ass bars and restaurants. They even restaurants that weren't even open. You know what I'm saying? I mean, yeah, that's cool. That's how you supposed to. You supposed to patronize and do you know what you need to do because a lot of people coming. You know what I'm saying? So at the same time, I'm not mad at him. I ain't say I'm mad or, you know, I'm concerned. I mean, I still paid everything that I had to pay. You know what I'm saying? It ain't like I slid through the crevices. You know what I'm saying? None of that shit, man. You know what I'm saying? But it was definitely, I wouldn't say scamming. Let's don't say scamming. It was taxing.
Right, that's a better word. I like
that. It was taxing. That's what it was, man. Scamming kind of crazy. Cause nobody wants scamming, and nobody wants scammers to get out of nothing. But I would say taxing.
Without it was an upcharge.
Representation.
Oh my no tax, God! No representation.
God dang, man. You know, CIAA been here. I think 3 years.
This probably my first time really indulging in it. You know what I'm saying? The other times, I think we was gone. We was
in Deep Creek or something, some shit like that. So that was last year. You know what I'm saying? So. Then the last year, I know I was working, so, but at the same time, so this was our time. We was like, all right, you know, we're gonna get out there, you know what I'm saying? I was missing him a couple times because he was doing some shit, so, like, we linked up back and forth, like, when we can really link up, but some of the footage that you gonna see is just, probably just, you know, Dread Man there, you know what I'm saying? Kid King was, just, you know what I'm saying, doing other stuff, like, little tech events and,
and culture. We're gonna take a quick break, let you stretch your leg, you can make a little bit.
Push
our students, faculty, staff, and alumni to be caught up in what's going on in tech, and in the sense that for HBCUs, they're so far behind compared to PWIs in the tech and innovation space. But from your perspective, now that you've been out and been successful, what takeaways can HBCUs learn from your experience to better set up their students, faculty, staff, and alumni to be better prepared and excel in the tech space?
Yeah, I mean, I think my message to any entrepreneurship group trying to develop entrepreneurs is like, I really think like VCs, you know, they pick trends and things that they want to go out and invest in because they think it's going to be a massive opportunity. I think there's a flavor of that in entrepreneur development that, but the special sauce that I think with marginalized communities is that it's not always, they're not always the same. And I give you an example, you know, you won't see financial inclusion or fintech really on anybody's list right now, but it should be in terms of our communities. I love, the one point in time, esports was a big deal, but I love the fact that Delane from PlayBS, he was able to connect the fact that a lot of us play video games. And how can I kind of create that as a sport for people in another aspect? There's just something about, like, there's some insights in marginalized communities that have massive opportunities. So they're not insights that are just attractive to us. I would try to develop entrepreneurs to attack those insights and problems. It's just, you know, I look at VCs and I look at that concept, but even at P&G, we built products based on human insight and human need. The product could be anything. And that's kind of how I approach Solo. When I wrote out the problem about the wealth gap, I did not know it would end up being this. I kind of just anchored on a problem. I think that's how you develop great entrepreneurs.
Anybody, my last question. Right there.
First, I'd like to say, Rodney, thank you. You're a black founder, you look like me. I'm a tech founder, Dante. My question to you is, I'm having a very challenging time getting people to believe in themselves, who I see have time, that I want to join my team to help build the next, you know, tech product that's going to actually solve a problem in the world, not just like a app idea. How do I get them to join forces? Because I'm like, I find myself having to preach to people, I'm like, you're on a hamster wheel, that's not working for you, right? And you have a skill set that aligns with mine. Why don't you come, you know, help us build this product to break that gap? But they don't see it. So as somebody like yourself, I just learned a lot. You know, you're super successful. What was something that you, you know, when you started 6 years ago that you had to, was it a pep talk? Was it friends? You know, was it strangers that you met? Can you give me some insight?
Yeah, it's hard for me to teach sometimes, but I can tell you how I did it, right? I think number one, don't worry about, like, the mere fact that you have recognized that you need to ask for help is the goal, right? Because I've always had co-founders. Not most of my co-founders, but some of my co-founders were complete strangers. Everybody eats with me. I cannot be in first class of myself. It's boring. So my point is that when you have an idea, you have to be like very self-aware to see what you're missing and then attract the best talent. You gotta think about it. It's ultimately gonna always provide more value for you. But I was really bad at it. How do you even attract someone who's like more talented than you to come work for you? Like, I don't even more educated. You got the stuff. You went to Harvard. You got the thing. I didn't got none of those things. I think you got to anchor on what you are good at, which no one can see your vision of whatever it is you only can see. Learning how to be persuasive. I had to read books. One of my, it was a book called I Think the Power of Influence. it was always talked about once you meet someone, like one of the tricks was like if you meet someone's name and you want to convince them to do something, you just keep saying their name. When you talk to them, it don't matter. People just love to hear their name. It works all the time. Like, go on a date, keep saying their name. Anyway. But the point is, I had to be a student at trying to be persuasive and charismatic. I had to learn it. Those things have nothing to do with education or anything. And we can all learn those things. And the point is, I really doubled down on that. I doubled down on it because I needed to make people, or I needed to convince people to work for me, sometimes for free. And I also needed to convince really white people to trust somebody they would never trust, right? And I'm just being very frank in that. So I had to learn how to like remove my ego, remove my mask, be persuasive, be charismatic, not just the people I'm comfortable being charismatic with, people that I was complete strangers with. So that's how I approached it. But it is a challenge. I also told everybody my idea. Don't be scared. If it's too simple of an idea and anybody can do it, it ain't a good idea. So if you can tell everybody in this room and all y'all can walk away and do it, it ain't that good of an idea. Do something. All my ideas, I would tell everybody, and they'd be like, I don't know how you gonna do that. That's wild. That's going crazy. That's a good idea. So hold up. So is it crazy, like crazy, or is it crazy like it's a massive opportunity that can help a lot of people? I just need a lot of help to do it. So start to unpack that. But I tell everybody so I can work on my pitch. My mom's pitch is a bite-sized elevator pitch. My mom can get it, that means I can spit it in the elevator. Other people need different types of pitches, right? I tell and talk to every single body who will let me listen. I'm perfecting myself. So those are the things that I continually do to develop someone's ideas.
And we're gonna wrap it up. Where can we reach out to you if they wanna chat with you, email, how do you get all of them?
I'm around. My email is Rodney@solofunds. You can always DM me. I have a friend in here who I met and she DM me and I will respond. I may not respond as much as you would like me to, but I promise you the reason why I'm here is because so many people that I DM or email also responded. So I have to return that favor.
I appreciate you, brother, for hanging out with us.
Thank you.
All right, love, peace, we're out, folks.
So, number one, being a black woman, leading a black woman team, or woman led team, and also having, you know, our end users being women and people of color. There's a lot of roadblocks ahead. One of them I'm talking about is funding, but outside of funding, really, the access to get into specific rooms or to have specific mentors that turn into sponsorship. I was recently tapped by LinkedIn to give my opinion on an article that was really talking about mentorship. And I really wanted to talk about not only how mentorship was important, but how sponsorship and getting advocates and champions that are not in the room with you when you're not there is extremely important. And it's not just important for professionals, it's important for founders too, because there's only so many rooms we can get to, especially someone like me who's an early stage founder, that my advisory board and my mentors and other people who are in different positions talking about the work I'm doing and the work that we can help advance is important. And another thing that I've always talked about is, you know, black women get less than 1% of VC capital. And that stat is consistently shown. But another thing that's not necessarily shown is all the additional barriers to get that VC capital. And how kind of this gratitude feeling of once you reach getting that capital, you should be happy with enough. And it's like, no, because it's not just capital we need. We need the resources, we need the people, we need the access, we need additional things to get from being a startup to being in the next stages, whatever exit looks like for that company. And I believe, you know, those are really the top things that I see myself face, but I see my black women peers, founder peers, they face.
That is doing some powerful things in Baltimore. The group is called Collectively,
and collectively proudly introduces the Black Future Cypher, directed and produced by Vaughn Vargas, showcasing talents of local Baltimore artists, Reggie, Black Assets, Icon the God, Shannon Ramsey, and K-Love the Poet. This crowdfunding and narrative endeavor has amassed over $54,000 in February alone, straight off of crowdfunding. Since its inception in 2019, collectively, a Baltimore-based catalyst for social change has dedicated over $2 million in unrestricted grants to bolster Black-led initiatives. I'm gonna say that one more time because I don't believe you heard me. They have raised over $2 million in unrestricted Black-led initiatives, okay? So give it up for that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Put your hands together and give a lot of energy to the Black Future Cypher!
All right, y'all, we about to kick it off. Black Future Cypher. We got my man Reggie, he about to kick it off.
What's up? Make some noise, y'all.
If you proud to be Black, y'all, I need y'all been here today.
Let's go.
That's right.
Shout out collectively.
That's right.
Vibe with me, give me energy. Woo! Survival in the building. Right now, I'm on the indefinite. Theme song for the movement. Around the world, there we go. They march on change. Spirit on Mars is burning. Celebrity, I live about money.
Vice President, Staff, Care First, one of the biggest contributors to the event today. So happy to have you today.
Hey man, I'm happy to be here. Thanks for having me. And look, what better place to be than in this city, in this time, with this energy? I mean, it's a gift. So thank you.
Yep, I love it. So we're going to jump right in, right? I ask everybody who comes to spend some time with me, right? Very first question. What is your definition of impact?
I love that. So my definition of impact is collaboration. And I'll tell you what I mean by that. You get folks who may have an idea about where they wanna go, may have a perspective about where they wanna go. And you can only do so much from an individual perspective. Same with a company. We have the same mantra, we care first. We've got resources. We've got an ability to do some things in community, and we can have that impact. We could do that. I'm really about how do we lock arms with other similar size, smaller size, bigger size institutions so that that impact that you could generate on your own is just exponentially greater. And I think for me, I've always wanted to tap in and plug into spaces and places where the thing that I offer, the thing that I can bring, can be scaled and grown so that we can do so much more for so many more people in community. And so for me, if you ask me about impact for me is really collaboration and scale. It's not necessarily what an individual can bring to that, although that's important. It's not what an individual company can bring, although that's important.
Yeah, I love this idea of like collaboration. I know prior to kicking off here, we were talking about some things that you're doing. Just give us an example of like how that collaboration shows up in the world right now.
So I'll give you an example. So I won't go deep into healthcare policy, but I will give you.
Thank you.
you know what I'm saying? Drag Dad was working, actually. So some of the tech stuff was actually happening during the daytime. And it was just a lot of events.
I was able to take my daughter to meetings and meet and greets
and all this stuff, different activities that they had during the daytime. So, you know what I'm saying, man? I worked, so, you know.
It was a good opportunity, you know what I'm saying? Take my daughter down there so she can see, you know what I'm saying? The things that her dad's like into, you know what I'm saying? I love tech stuff, I'm a computer geek. And I want like a lot of change for my city, and a lot of people's talking about, you know, entrepreneurship and just understanding the growth and the power of the black dollar and how networking can kind of bring us, you know, closer to that forefront where we need, where we can start investing into ourselves and not being afraid to invest, knowing that the product is coming out good and that blacks can present good, great products. So now black investors won't be scared thinking they'll lose their money investing into black products. But you know, we're black products, so come invest in us. Like, comment, subscribe.
Yes, sir. Jersey Kings Unfiltered, man.
Jersey Kings Unfiltered.
You know what I'm saying, man? So the only thing that we just try to see, man, like for real, you know, it was a lot of events, man. We couldn't just go to every one. One day we went 4 or 5 events. You know what I'm saying? So it was just, everything was just tax season. But at the same time, I mean, I really enjoyed myself, man. We had fun. I was out with the gang. I was out, you know what I'm saying? We just was vibing, man. Everything was top notch, man. All the event spots, everything was just really like
the atrium, that
joint was lit every goddamn night. They must have had a contract with them.
Right, they was getting
god dang, boy, every time,
top money makers.
God, I know they made 2 mil. That joint, I was in one joint like this. I couldn't even move. Every time I move around, I'm like,
got the infamous.
But it was sections.
More than a hustle, I'm the definition of it. Master chef, lord of the kitchen cupboard. More than a street legend, homie, it's Hover. More than a relief pitcher, I'm the closer. The Mariano of the Marriott. If money talks, the whole world about to hear me out. See, I'm a hustler's hope, I'm not his pipe dreams. So when they speak of success, I'm what they might mean. Attract money, my worst color is light green. My favorite hue is Jay-Z blue. Don't follow me, young, and follow my moves. I'm not a role model. A bad influence got the world drinking gold bottles. When Puff was in that tub spilling mo-
That joint was real nice, you know what I'm saying? But it was sections. You know what I'm saying? So that's what we're gonna go into. Our second topic, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's sections good or sections bad, or like, I mean, I guess back in the day it wasn't no sections, man.
Well, if it was a section, it was only like a 1-2 area.
Right, nobody went over there. So now right. It's like every time you go out,
whole place
you gotta buy a section. And then some of them be saying that you just reserve a section. And then you still gotta do everything else. Like, so you reserving a section, right? And then you still gotta pay extra for your bottle. And you still gotta tip the server. And you gotta tip this tip. I mean, it's more so back to taxing. You know what I'm saying? But this one is more so, is the clubs better now than I can say, what is 2020? I just say 2020. Or was the clubs better? I won't even say clubs. Clubs or events. Better in, I would say, 2000. So we talking 25 years ago. You know what I'm saying?
How it changed.
How it evolved.
I like the party.
Some people don't like the party. To everything, I mean, everything is just a section. You know what I'm saying? So then when you go into the section parties, right? We ain't come to sit down anyway, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. We don't come from that era that you want to sit down, you know what I'm saying?
Stand around, look at
every other, we ain't worried about nobody else, you know what I'm saying? So at the same time, now you want to sit down, right? And then you almost subject to only being that same area.
You can't, you let your old man.
You miss everybody. You know, everybody came past. Nobody don't even know you was there. Because you was in the section.
I'm in the section. Yo, like,
man, come on, man. It don't even be a section. They gave me a tabletop. They gave me a tabletop, right? Oh, yeah, five people can sit. A tabletop, bro? That's barely fit my food. You know what I'm saying? Me and my lady can't even fit the food that I'm gonna get, you know what I'm saying? Like, cause I'm gonna eat. I'm definitely gonna eat wherever I go. It gotta be food. I love food. You know what I'm saying? I'm not just gonna come there drinking. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't a drinker anyway. But you know what I'm saying? I used to be a drinker. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, like, nah, it's crazy, man. Like a section, everything is section. Sections like a section. Even when you go to a hookah spot, it's a section.
Section, right?
A hookah spot.
You're already gonna sit down
at a hookah spot because you gotta sit down and, you know what I'm saying? You can't walk around with your little hookah. Right. You know what I'm saying? I mean, they got little portable hookahs, but they ain't doing them jumps at the hookah spot. So at the same time, like a section or not a section. So at the same time, we went to all these clubs, all the, you know, Thursday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday. Boom, I think it was Sunday.
Sunday,
boom, man. Yeah, you know, it's
free Sunday.
Free Sunday. So now it's all these free parties. Cause you know why? Cause they was taxing us they probably started Monday through Saturday. They taxed you. So now they're like, all right, I'm just gonna throw a little free one in there, right? It wasn't even on the agenda. I'm gonna throw a little free one in there. Boom, boom, boom. Throw a little free one in there, right? Everybody like, oh yeah. If you know, you know. I don't care if you got whatever money in your pocket, but when something come up free, and you know it's gonna be that. And guess what? Guess what he didn't have?
No section.
No section.
No sections.
That thing was wall to wall. I mean, okay, yeah, it's free. Yeah, of course, everybody, oh, it's free. Yeah, but I'm just saying, to pack something like that, you know what I'm saying, with no sections, right? So you can't go in there, you know what I'm saying, you got a little set. Nah. Yeah. Telling you, man. Yeah, it was nice.
No, ending of the party was nice, just to see everybody be able to filter from inside to outside and keep it peaceful and just all just chill amongst there. It was like we was at the park or something like that.
Yeah, it definitely felt like Drew Hill.
It felt like old time Drew Hill.
Yeah, man, old time Drew Hill, man. Everybody
tripping, chilling. Hey, seeing people you ain't seen in a long time. Oh, yo, what's good, yo? Dang, I ain't seen him in about 20 years, yo. Fuck, he was looking like, I don't feel like I'm in. about 20 years, yo. Fuck, you was going, like, you know what I mean, yo?
Yeah, it was free, yo. Just imagine with a section and all that, da 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 da, man. You wouldn't even saw nobody, man. Everybody was sitting down, party been boring. People been, you know what I'm saying? I don't think sections, to me, that the party be lit when you got a section. You know what I'm saying? Oh, everybody that comes to the section, everybody gonna just stay right there because that's where you at. But if you moving around and you standing up, you right here, boom, boom, we can.
Social, man.
Like,
come on, the old Bond Street social. You see, social. That word social means something. It doesn't mean anti-social. Like, if that's what y'all want the club called, call them anti-social clubs. But people went to social clubs, you know what I'm saying? We didn't go to anti-social clubs. So, I just like to hear y'all take on. Do y'all like sections? Do y'all hate people that much that y'all got to stay combined? And y'all okay with being confined to one little space?
Like, right, and that's what I want to know. Like, do y'all like sections yourself?
Right.
How y'all feel? Like, how y'all feel about it? Like, for real?
Sections is for me. Like I said, I'm too hyperactive.
Sections is boring and phony and overrated, man.
You spend a whole bunch of money in this lawyer spot.
You get these low ass bottles of Don Julio. The bottle probably like this little, man. The bottle probably that little, man. That low ass bottle of Don Julio. It probably that much in there. You know what I'm saying? Fuck around, don't you be. You know, the amount in there, because they trimming the bottles.
These shots, oh yeah, I heard about that. I've seen some posts around here saying they talking about how they doing these bottles in these clubs, man. Y'all gotta, like my man Moose said, you better wait one, you better check one when you come to these bottles, man.
Yeah, because they doing that to steaks too. Talking about they give you a 20-ounce steak, man. You get out that joint, man. You pull your joint out, man. That joint 17.5, man.
Crazy.
Ain't no way, man. Send it back. I don't want the steak, man. Send it back.
Crazy.
Hey, man. Crazy. You get the bottle, you give out. All right, already the section already say, oh, then we're going to sit six. You already know six ain't going to come. There's going to be probably 10 of y'all, 10, 12 of y'all. So just imagine, right? We still order 2-3 bottles. I ain't talking about the bottles and how much it is and all that. I'm talking about we might still order 3. All right, first we're going to start with 2 bottles, right? Minimum. Boom. Yeah, I mean, they come, girls come out, hey, right? Boom, hey. They come, little juice come out, right? And then, 10 minutes later, everybody looking at everybody else, like, is we getting another bottle? We like, come on, man. Like, come on, man. Like, I'm not saying, like, yeah, we got guzzlers with us. Yeah, I ain't saying that. Yeah, people definitely drink, but what I'm saying is, the shit be gone. There's no way possible that is what 16 shots.
16
shots. 16 shots in a bottle, right?
In a fifth. 16 shots
right?
In a fifth.
That little bottle is supposed to be a fifth that we get. It can't be. It can't be nothing else. It gotta be a fifth. You're not getting 16 shots.
I don't care.
You're not getting 16 shots.
I was about to pour.
Guess what you're gonna get? You're gonna get 8.
Anybody want a double and a half? Well,
you gonna get
1.5 shots.
You guaranteed to get 8 shots. That's 2 bottles, 16 shots now. Now we got 16 shots. Then you gonna go get another bottle, right? And you still thirsty because everybody else still gonna want some drinks. We just got this. I'm trying to tell you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Right, it's over, man. Yeah. Whole night gone, man. You probably got 6 bottles coming. It's been
12 hours.
All because it's a section.
You had that little cup going around, hey boy. Throw a Long Island up in you or something, yeah boy. You know we blow it down in the club too, hey.
You know we blow it down in the club. Any club, any establishment.
I see they try to stop niggas down in the peninsula.
Oh
man,
my
said,
God.
Fuck y'all.
Boy, man, you, man, boy. Said, I'm trying to tell you, man, listen, man. I'm trying to tell you, man, we partied in a lot of different states, a lot of different places. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it never, I'm talking about, I never came to nowhere that it was that many phony-ass security guards, mm-hmm. man. I'm talking about a nigga came out there with the shiesty mask. Right? So mind you, at first he ain't had a shiesty mask on. He was all, you know what I'm saying? He still was on his shit, though. He still was, yeah, y'all can't do this in hell. He never said nothing to me, because I'm telling you, I was going straight, yeah. But he never said nothing to me. Whole time, just keep on running up on people. Keep on running up on people. It seemed like somebody was watching at the door. We on the outside deck, man. We already paid $60 to $100 each person to get in this joint, right?
I'm not saying every place you can smoke at. So let's clear it up, right? I'm not saying that. I'm not saying we was smoking inside, right? Mind you, Maryland and Baltimore, whatever, is we legal for recreational marijuana, period, right? So at the same time, I would say 75% of the people in there want to smoke. I'm not even going to call it 50%. It's 75% of the people that was in there that wanted to smoke. Ready, ready, right? Soon as we get there, guess what? Guess what it said? It got signs out. No vaping. No, you can't bring a lighter in. You couldn't even bring a lighter, right? You couldn't bring a lighter in. You couldn't even bring a vape pen, man. A vape pen. You can't bring a vape pen in somewhere that's, okay, yeah, you can't smoke with, yeah, you want vape. At least you want vape. And if you don't want vape inside, you got a little deck. So we go outside. You know what I'm saying? It was a nice day. Mosey on outside. Yeah, we had fun. But now you telling that a girl that drink, right? You know when people get drunk, boy, they gotta smoke something. You know what I'm saying? So at the same time, telling a girl that drink, that brought drinks from your place, you know what I'm saying? That we already spent the money. We spent the money getting, yeah. That you, come on, man. Stop it, man. That's just like fussing with a woman. You ain't gonna never win, man. Come on, man. But they told everybody that we can't have all that in there, man. Still was in there. That's what I'm just trying to tell you. So we still was in that bitch smoking. We still had big pens. We still had everything. So at the same time, man, y'all should just let us smoke. So let's get back to rebuttal back to the dude. The dude coming out there every time, you know what I'm saying, 3-4 times, right? He never had a Shacey mask on that time. Now, boy, he come out, boy, he's probably like 2 hours later. We still was getting to try to get it in. Don't come out there with the Shacey mask on. Right? Then he come out with like 9 people. It's like 9 of them now. So I guess your pool shite is motherfucking Brick Squad or whatever. Fucking them niggas. 10-17 niggas, you feel me? Chapman game niggas. So at the same time, right? These niggas had like Lord tasers. He ain't had one. See? He ain't say nothing. He ain't do all. He ain't wild out, but he ain't, you know. The other ones had Lord tasers on them. That's why they came out there. He was ready. What the fuck is going on? I was inside then. You know what I'm saying? What the fuck is going on? But that was the worst place ever in life that you couldn't smoke in.
Tell me how the one nigga though at the last spot, what he said? One security guard, he ran down on you. He said, what strand is that?
Don't ask, yo, oh my God. Hey, yo, hold up. Y'all was just about to say, yo. Yo, a security, you was there? Yo, the security guard, ran down on me, right? We were chilling, laid back, you know what I'm saying? Smoking, we outside the establishment, though. Yo, come over there, nice and calm. I mean, you know you gonna say something, but yo, come over there, nice and calm, and say, yo, what strain are you smoking? I say, boy, come on, man. What it is, man? What's up, yo?
I'm trying to clear it out,
yo. We just trying to clear it out, man. I'm like,
you smell that donkey.
I'm like, all right, yo, I'm finished rolling up. And mind you, I ain't even had it lit. I'm rolling it up. So at the same time, he like, which strand is that? So y'all be smelling in the, you know what I'm saying? In the, like, I'm about to roll it up like this. So at the same time, right? I said, all right, yo, we gonna, you know what I'm saying, finish doing what we doing, and then, yeah, we got you. All right, man, just take your time. But what I'm saying is, why, you just want to let us know, why you even come over there? You gonna ask me which strand, like, you ready to buy some grass on the clock? And then I think he did say that, because I said, all right, y'all got you. And then he was like, yo, I'm on the clock.
He probably was watching us the whole time. Come on, man. Seeing where that smoke was coming from. Oh, that's...
Yeah, because we did have a blunt lit before, but I already had a little piece that had me on the walk. So I lit that joint up while I rolled another one.
Outside.
But it was mad people out there, other than me. Yeah, it wasn't just like it was just me and him. Me and Kid King. You know what I'm saying? It's Dre, man. Kid King. You feel me? But at the same time, smoke that gas, man. That gas pack, man. Ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? And that's our third time. The gas, man. Weed. You know what I'm saying? Like, so at the same time, man, like, crazy, man. Like, I don't know. I don't know, man. Like, for real,
You know what I'm saying? I ain't no drinker like that. I mean, ever since I came back from Mexico like a year and a half ago, and everybody said, boy, you been drinking, you been drinking. I guess so. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, I just got used to it now. At first, I didn't care for it, but now I want me some Reposado. Can I get me a little cup of Reposado with like 3 pieces of ice cubes? That's it. I ain't trying to hurt nothing. You know what I'm saying? Three ice cubes and a Repo. You know what I'm saying? And that's it, man. I might chill on that. And then I'm going to get a little Long Island. You know what I'm saying? Then chill on that. And then I'm cool. Right there, you know what I'm saying? Then I'm laid back, man. You know, I ain't trying to hurt nothing.
The best drink right there, that Longy. That's that best one.
I quit that sample. This one for my man. Yeah, man. Yes. Skola was out here doing what he do. You know what I'm saying? A couple concerts. You know what I'm saying? Morgan couldn't have Al homecoming, you know what I'm saying? You know, East Baltimore homecoming, I want to say, you know what I'm saying? Like, Cotton from West. You know what I'm saying? Shit happened. You know what I'm saying? Something happened at the school. And, you know what I'm saying? One thing led to another. You know what I'm saying? Send my prayers to everybody. You know what I'm saying? That was involved. You know what I'm saying? But we ain't have Al shit, man. That shit would have been, you know what I'm saying? We would have definitely had some footage on that. We would have definitely been there, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? My cousin DJ, you feel me? DJ Tidy, you know, Hot Tidy, you feel me? You know what I mean? Like, so, yeah, it definitely would have been very, very interesting if we would have had it, or made content, whatever you want to call it.
Hey, well, that shit looked lit up there. Who you
saying
he bought somebody
else? Yo, boy, check out, man. Check game is flowers, man. Yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? Yo, that shit was lit. Yeah, I mean, like, yeah, man. That shit was, you know what I'm saying? A real, genuine gesture that he did. You feel me? Yeah, man, I'm trying to tell you, man, like, yeah, the concert was lit, you feel me? It was just some vibes here, man, over the CIAA, though. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Good time, good folks.
People came down like that, Money Bag Yo down here.
Big Tig was down here.
DJ Emmy was down here, you feel me?
Envy.
For Jess Elias was down here, little party, you feel me? They had Money Bag Yo, was that there?
Yeah,
YTB Fat.
They said
Shador was down here with Desi. I mean, Desi Banks was down here.
Desi Banks, man. And it was lit. Yeah, that bitch was everywhere. It was everywhere.
Yeah, everybody down here. And we had, I think, they had like some singers down here.
2 months. Next year I'm gonna be more prepared. We're gonna be more prepared for y'all.
No, it definitely was a nice. Oh, Sugiyani, put the butter on the nigga. Put the butter on the nigga's face. Nigga had the shazzy man. Nigga, she straight come. Boom, boom. Boy. Boy. Like a city yachty sub. You hear me? Boy, that shit was crazy. Man. Everything was love, man. Everything was genuine. There was enough people down here from every state. I guarantee it was.
I wanted to go down the hall. I'm saying all the people up in the lower, they got the little merch store with all the college stuff down the hall. We walked into there. They selling all the college stuff. It was teams represented from places like schools I didn't even know. I'm looking for Morgan. I'm like, man,
I didn't even find no Morgan stuff.
But I found out that we ain't really a part of the CIAA, so Like I said, I'm just learning also. And I wasn't running down North Carolina back when niggas was going down and see when it was down there. That's when I first got introduced to CIAA. I want to know how we compare. I need some people that win them both. Tell me how
right,
we can pay.
Right. Put it in the comment.
Right. What we need to do. We need to step our game up. Or what?
Is we there? You know what I'm saying? Was it like just like, you know what I'm saying, North Carolina? Was it just like North Carolina? When you see CIAA, was it what y'all wanted like from it or what you got from it? Or
next we need to get to the games too. I want to see some of the games. I ain't get to go.
Yeah, man, the game was early, so I couldn't go, man.
Yeah, they was on a deadline.
On a deadline, man, so it was lower. And then at night, by the time of night, you just wanted
ready to be out.
You was ready to want to just party or something, you know what I'm saying? So you didn't really want to go to the game.
About that, right? You even locked in a little building. But yeah, I seen they had a whole nice little road past CFG Bank. What is it called? CFG Bank. I like how they put like a whole food truck little spot. They blocked off part of Park Avenue, I think that's Park right there. And just in case that in and let all the food vendors get their thing right there. That's dope, because, I don't want y'all walking around and keep going up Lexington and Mountain and all that. There ain't nothing up there too much yet. It's nice. Country, man.
We love Lexington Market, man.
I love it.
Sunnyside, man. You get that breakfast, man. If you ever come to Baltimore, go to Lexington Market, man. Go to Sunnyside Cafe. You feel me? I'm telling you. And get that Captain Crunch French Toast, man. Get that Captain Crunch French Toast, you know what I'm saying? And get some eggs with no cheese, you know what I'm saying? Get some bacon, you know what I'm saying? And she gonna put a little strawberry. She gonna put a little strawberry in there for you too. You feel me? Get extra butter and syrup. And then you gotta get that triple mix. Oh my God. You get that triple mix, boy, you going bad. I'm telling you. Yeah, you gotta get two of them though. You gotta get two. You gotta get two. You gotta get two. Can't just get one, you gotta get two.
That's how you do down here. Get two and come back and get that four piece. That's fried across the street from Parks. That's a good fried chicken.
Come on, Ringo.
place compared to North Carolina because I ain't never go. But if you went, you know what I'm saying? Put in a comment. Like, what you think better? North Carolina, Baltimore, or just be the same. You know what I'm saying? Just want your opinion. That's all, man. Some little bit of interaction with y'all guys, man, out here, man. You know what I'm saying? Let's go.
Ba ba boom. This gonna end it for us, you know what I'm saying, this week. It's been a long week.
Definitely been a long week.
Niggas been tired of shit, you know. Went to house parties and niggas was sleeping. Boy, enter this gun and put cheese sticks in them.
God dang, man. Don't talk about the cheese sticks and
the pizza and shit like that, man. People get offended, man, when they don't get a piece. You know what I'm saying? So like, everybody want a piece, man. Everybody can't get a piece. You know what I'm saying?
I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying? Everybody can't get a piece.
Ain't
enough pieces out here to get them. So, you know what I'm saying? So once you get one piece, in the day, man, I'm down to a little piece.
So like, no, I gotta keep it. It's just mine. It's my pieces.
Yeah.
I had that good food that's gonna feed that
belly.
Right?
Let me keep that belly full.
Belly full so you can enjoy yourself.
Enjoy yourself, man. We done with another Dre's and King's Unfiltered
Session
6. You know what I'm saying? We out here. You know what I'm saying? We in the streets, man. We trying to give y'all real lives. You know what I'm saying? Contents.
Keep rocking with us.
Keep rocking with us, man. Just keep vibing. You know what I'm saying? All of you rocking with y'all. You know what I'm saying? We don't own the rights to none of that music. You know what I'm saying? We put up. But you know what I'm saying? Like, if anybody listen to it, you know what I mean? Just listen to it. You know what I'm saying? The day we was just YBS Scola. We joined. You feel me? Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Session 6.
Peace out.